गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम योर टीचर। यस्टरडे आई हैव टॉट यू साइंस, टुडे आल्सो वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द सेम लेक्चर। बिफोर दैट वी विल स्टार्ट विद अ स्मॉल प्रेयर। डू यू ऑल नो ओम भूर्भुवस्वः श्लोक? शो योर थंब लाइक दिस। यस, सो all join your hands, sit straight first of all. Join your hands. Yes. Close your eyes and we are going to say the small shlok of Om Bhurbhuvasvaha. Okay? All are going to say. Don't on your speaker, only just say it. I can see on the camera, right? Come on, we'll start. Om Bhurbhuvasvaha. तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गो देह स धीमहि धियो यो न प्रचोदयात्। ओके, ऑल सिट स्ट्रेट, रब योर हैंड्स लाइक दिस, रब योर पाम्स, प्लेस इट ऑन योर फेस, डू टू टाइम्स। ऑल स्टूडेंट्स आर गोइंग टू डू टू टाइम्स। यस स्टूडेंट्स, यू प्लेस योर कैमरा प्रॉपरली। Okay, yes, all are going to sit straight. Okay, yesterday we have learnt about human skeleton. Yes or no? Show your thumb like this. Okay, yes, today we are going to continue the same chapter, but it will be about bones, different parts. Okay, yesterday we have learnt about a skeleton of various animals. Yes, I have shown you the picture, skeleton of different animals, right? Horse, dinosaur. Yes, can you recollect that? Yesterday I have shown you the pictures. Yes, so today we are going to learn about human body. Yes,
I done yesterday homework.
Yes. I'll be checking it afterwards. Okay, after I'll finish my part, then I'll be checking the homework. Okay, yes, good girl. So we are going to understand about human skeleton, and the main part is the brain. Okay, I have told you yesterday what are the main organs and what functions the organs are doing. Okay, today we are going to understand deeply about the skull, about the bones. Okay, what are the internal organs, what is the skeleton properly maintained about. Okay, about the joints, how many joints are there, how many bones are there. Okay, we are going to understand about that. Okay, I'll be sharing you one screen. In that screen, it will be a brief discussion about the human skeleton. Okay, I'll be explaining you that also. Okay, you just have to see the screen and you just have to understand in it. Okay, is it okay? See children, this is the topic, today's topic. Okay, so our topic is our skeleton system and the skin. Today we are going to learn about human skeleton. Okay, Yes, children. As a body grows, the size and length of our bones increases. See, when you are a child, can you all hear me, students?
Yes.
Okay, okay. As a body grows, the size and length of our bones increases. Such changes in size and length can be seen in children according to the age. See, children, when we grow from a child, newborn baby to an adult, we have different changes in our body, right? So these gradual changes, it makes an increase in the bones also. Okay, when your body is growing, each and every part is growing accordingly. Okay, however, the body continues to grow only up to a certain limit. The bones of taller people are longer. See, when a short child is there, the bones of the short child will be small as per his height and body, right? When a bone of a tall people is there, the bone will be as longer as the height of the child. Okay, understood all of you? Yes. See, children, here you can understand about the parts of human skeleton. See, these parts are the movable parts. Can you see? These are the movable parts. Can you see on the screen, children? See how the body parts are moving. The hand, the wrist, okay? The skull. See, in the skull, only the jaw is moving, right? Understood? Yes. So this is a part of human skeletal system. The rib cage. Can you all see, children? See, this is a skull. The head part is the skull, okay? The chest part is a rib cage, okay? It is like a rib. Then below that you have a spine, that is a spinal cord of your back, okay? Then you have hand, that is arm part. And down is the leg part. Can you see in the picture the red part is there? That red part is the spinal part, okay? Then in legs also you have the joint, okay? Then in hands, you have the same joint. You can move your parts of the body, hands, wrist, okay, elbows. You can move from up and down, rightwards, backwards. You can move your hands, okay? The head part, you cannot move. The head part, you cannot move. Only the jaw is movable. Can you see? Touch your jaw, teeth part down. Touch your chin, all of you. See, it is moving or not. When you talk, it is moving, right? But the other parts, it doesn't move, right? The nose doesn't move from here and there. The ear doesn't move from here and there. Okay? Understood, children? Now, the actual skeleton. See, children, the skull is formed by the bones of the head and face. See, there are 22 altogether bones in the skull. 8 in the head and 14 in the face, okay? Except the lower jaw, none of the bones of the skull can move. See, I have told you, only the jaw can move. The teeth part, the mouth part is only movable, okay? The other parts are not movable, okay, in the skull. Right, children? Then, coming to the next part, see the actual skeleton of the chest part now, okay? Feel the left and the right side of the chest with your hand or finger. How many bones can you feel all together on the two sides? Check in the center. How many bones do you feel? Now, if you touch your body part, children, you will feel, somehow you will feel that this is a bone part, this is the skin part, okay? Understood, children? Then, the cage-like structure in the chest is called as a rib cage. See, in the chest part, the red part is there in the picture, that is called as a rib cage. Okay, in the chest, there is one vertical flat bone called the sternum. 12 pairs of flat bones called ribs are joined to the sideways. See, children, the rib cage in the picture, you can see they are joined to each other. Can you all see they are joined to the spinal cord? Can you see, children? These 25 bones form a rib cage. It is joined to the spine at the back. See, all these are joined to each other. Okay, there are total how many bones in the rib cage? 25 bones in the rib cage. I'll be asking you after this, after the class, children. See in the skull, once again I'm showing you all. See how many 22 bones are there in the skull? 8 in the head and 14 in the face. Okay, keep in mind, children. Then we have the lower spine area. See, it is in the back part of our body. Can you touch your back part so you can understand what is there in the back part? See, you can see a small cord-like structure is there in your back. That is called as a spine. The spine is formed by the padlock-shaped bones placed straight one above the other. There are altogether 33 bones in the spine, each called a vertebra. What are the bones in the spine called as? Vertebra, okay? These bones are arranged one above the other, but they are what? Flexible, okay? You can bend down, you can become straight, again you can go rightwards, again you can go leftwards. So that is called as the flexible part of our body, okay? The spine protects the spinal cord that originates from the brain. Okay, now this spine is from the brain. It is attached from the brain to the lower part of our back. Okay, what would have happened if we didn't have a backbone? What will happen? Can anyone tell me? If you don't have a backbone, what will happen? Can you stand straight? Yes, children. Okay, we'll talk later, okay? Okay, see, now, this is the appendicular skeleton. See, in the picture, you can see a elbow, okay? You can see a leg part from below the thighs, okay? See, when you sit, your legs can bend. You can bend your legs in front way or backward. You can sit on your legs also. Arms also, you can elbow also, you can bend it backward, frontward, up, down, okay? You can do these all things. They are the joint parts, okay? The human body has two arms and two legs. The different parts of the arms and legs have several bones which are connected together by the joints. Now, these joints, we are going to understand deeply, okay? Now, see all children, when you sit down, okay? When you sit down, what happens? You sit down, fold your legs, and then only you can sit, right? Or other case, you can sit on your legs, okay? You can sit on your back, okay? Then, when you have PT exercises, right, children? What is the main part in the PT exercises? Rightwards, upwards. We do our hands like this, right? Up, hands down. What is there in the soldier? The shoulder is consisting of a ball-like joint, okay? So, it can go back, it can go up, it can go sidewards, okay? These are called as the joints, okay? See, these are the joints. Now, these joints, some joints are movable and some joints are immovable, okay? See, you can see in the picture. Joints are the places where two or more than two bones are connected to each other. Okay? More than two bones can be connected. These are called as joints. These joints you can see in your elbows. You can see in your legs. Okay? It is there in the foot also. Okay? See, movable joints. You can see in the picture. See, it's a hand. Bones can move. Bones of arms and legs can move, okay? Immovable joint, bones cannot move. That is the part of our skull, okay? The only jaw part is movable. Other than jaw, no other part is movable, okay? See, children. This is the actual skeleton. This type of joint allows the movement of bones only in one direction. It moves in an angle of 180 degree. The elbow and the knee joints. Okay? See, children. the knee part, that is called as a hinge joint. Okay. See in the picture, you can see the hand can move backwards and upwards. Okay. But the hand, full hand cannot go back and it cannot go rotate like this. Okay. Only the shoulder part is movable. Can you see? Take your hands like sidewards. Move your hands, children, so you will understand. Okay. See, your hands go back. Check whether your hands go back 180 degree angle. Yes or no? That is called as hinge joint. Okay. Now, coming to the next part. This is a ball or socket joint. See, a ball type structure is there in the shoulder part. Okay. See, in this type of joint, the bones can move into two or more directions. In a 3600 angle, okay, the shoulder and the hip joints. You can bend your shoulder, you can make your shoulder back, you can take your shoulder front, you can take your shoulder up, down, okay. These are called as the ball-like structure, that is called as a ball and socket joint, okay. You can see in the picture, children, how it is, how the joint is there in the shoulder, okay. Then. In this type of joint, the bones can only slide over each other. Wrist and ankles joint. See, children, that is a gliding point. It is in the wrist. Understood? The wrist part, we are having a gliding joint. Now, coming to the skin, the main important part of our body. Children, above the bones, you have the skin, and the skin is what it is protecting the bones of our body, right? The skin, what does the skin do? It is the outermost cover of the body. Okay, what happens when you go in sun? What happens when you go in sun? We get a small sunburn, right? Okay, what happens? You can feel the sunburn, okay. When it is winter season, we can feel the sunburn. We can feel the winter, right? How we can feel the winter? See, children, there are the layers of skin. In the picture, see the pink part, the red part down, the dotted parts. These are the different layers of skin, right? The outermost covering of the body is called skin. The structure of the skin. Human skin is made of two main layers. The outermost layer is called as the epidermis, which is above one, which we can feel it, which can touch it, okay? And the layer below, it is called as the dermis. Below the dermis, there is a network of blood vessels and nerve fibers. See, when you get a cut, when you get a hit somewhere, what happens? Suddenly, blood comes out. Okay, that is where, from where the network inside the skin, you have what blood vessels. Okay, these blood vessels, what does it do? It gives us blood out. Okay, when you get a cut, the substantial layer under this network maintains normally body temperature. The epidermis has various layers. Now, in this skin also, you have many such layers. Okay. Understood, children? Now, see, what is the function of the skin? What does the skin do? See, first point is protecting the internal parts of the body like muscles, bones, organ systems, etc. What does the skin do? It protects the internal parts. If we do not have skin, what will happen? The bones can be seen easily, right? Which it doesn't have to be happened. Help preserve the moisture in the body. Synthesizing vitamin D. Releasing sweat to regulate body temperature. Giving protection from the heat and cold. The skin functions as the sensory organs of touch. See, you must have learned sensory organs. So skin is the sensory organ. You all know, right? Now, in this skin, you have a melanin type that is a pigment, which is called as a melanin, which is present in the cell of epidermis. We have understood epidermis in the skin part. Okay, the uppermost layer is the skin part. Okay, the melanin is synthesized in certain glands in the skin. The percentage of melanin decides the fairness and darkness of the skin. See, children, all the human being is not dark, or all the human being is not white. Okay, all the people is having different texture of the skin. Okay, the color of the skin also depends on the climate. Okay, when you go other part of the country, you have a different types of people. Okay, some are too fair, some are too black. Okay, so these depends on the climate of the area. Okay, melanin protects our skin and the inner parts of ultraviolet sun rays. Understood? Now, see, children, this I have shown you all. Yes. So, who is going to tell me what does the skin consist of? Who is going to tell me? See, I have shown you the skin part. Now, I'll be showing you my hand. See, can you see my hand, children? See? Yes. This is the skin. All touch your skin. All students, keep the hand in your camera so you will understand it properly, children. See, this is the skin part, right? Inside the skin, touch your skin like this. You will feel the bone. Can you feel the bone? Can you feel here? These are what? Joints. See, here also you are having joint part, right? See, you have, do you have joints? This we have seen the picture. Okay, so these are the joints. In elbows also, see, you can move your elbow. See, can you move your elbow? So these are the joints in you. Can you move? You can move it. Can you move it like this? Can this shoulder come to this side? Is it like that? Can this shoulder come to this side? No. Only this will be having a ball or joint part. Okay? Understood, all of you? Now, in the skull, see, this is your skull, right? This is your head part. Can you move this? Can you move this? Can you move this? Is your eyes moving, coming out? Is your ear coming out? No. So, the movable part is only your jaw. You can talk, okay? You can keep your mouth shut whenever you want. What does it happen? Your brain is giving some command. That time only, you are doing some action. Understood? This is the part of the skull. Understood, all of you? Now, skeleton. Yes, very good. So, I think you all have understood, right? Human skeleton, what is the actual skeleton? Okay, we have understood about the joints. How many joints we have understood? Yes, can anyone tell me? How many joints we have understood? Hinge joint, okay? It is there in the legs. When you sit down, what happens? When you sit down, what happens? Can you sit spreading your legs? Can you sit spreading your legs? You can fold your legs. You can sit properly. You can sit on your legs. Okay? So, these are the movable joints. Understood? Yes or no? Yes. In the skull, how many bones are there? Can anyone give me the answer?
Yes, miss.
How many bones are there? Yes. Who is going to give me the answer? How many bones are there in the skull?
24 bones.
Yes, very good. Yes. Okay, 22 bones, but 8 bones are what? Where are the 8 bones? Yes, very good. 8 bones are in the head and 14 bones are in the other part of the face. Okay, understood? So you all understood? Yes. Okay. How many bones are there in full body? Full body. Yesterday I have told you all.
There are 206 bones.
Very good. Okay. So you all have understood, right? Now, yesterday we have understood about the skeleton of various animals. Which animals I have showed you all? Yes. Which were the animals I have showed?
There's a dinosaur.
Yes.
Horse.
Yes. Then fish. Okay. Then snake also we have understood. Okay. We have seen the skeleton of snake also. Now, in the body part, okay, in the body part, where is the rib cage? Where is the rib cage? Yes. Where you can see the rib cage? What is this? What is this? Can you see in the picture of me?
In our chest.
Yes, rib cage is in our chest. Very good. Very good. Now, where is the spinal cord? Spinal cord. Where is it? Spinal cord is in our back. Okay? Understood? So, we have understood how many bones are there, how many bones are there in the rib cage, what is the importance of rib cage. If we don't have rib... Yes, very good. Yes, children. If we don't have any of this part, what will happen? If we don't have spinal cord, then what will happen?
Back will be not straight.
Yes. We cannot bend like this. We cannot move straight like this. Okay. We cannot do exercises. We cannot stand. Okay. If we don't have spinal cord, we cannot stand. Okay. Understood? So each and every body part from our head to the toe is very much important. Okay. Without any of the body part, we cannot survive. Okay. Understood? Some of the other thing will be happened. Okay. Now, what can you tell me about movable joints? Movable joint. Which one is the movable joint? Yes, very good, Tanmay. Movable joints, yes. And which are the immovable joints? Yes, head. Head part is the immovable. That is called as a skull, okay? That is called as skull. Only the jaw can move, yes. So you have understood what I have taught you, right? Now, I will be giving you the question answers. Yesterday, I have given you the question answers, right? I want the answers from that question answers. And today also, I will be giving you some questions. You have to answer that. I will be asking you now. You are going to give me the answer, right? Okay. First one. Ball and socket joint. Where can you find ball and socket joint? Where can you find that ball and socket joint? I have shown you in the picture. Ball and... Yes, very good, Anuja. Yes, it is in the shoulder. Okay? Yes, very good. Then hinge joint. Where can you see hinge joint?
What, teacher?
Hinge, H-I-N-G-E, hinge joint.
Knee.
Yes, very good. It is in the knee part. Okay. What is the knee part? It is our leg part, right? Then gliding joint. gliding joint?
Hand.
Yes, it is in the wrist. Okay, you see, if you do like this, see, your wrist is moving, right? You can move it backwards, you can move it upwards. See, like this. Do all children do in the camera? See, check it whether all the wrists are moving or not. Yes, do it upwards, do it downwards. Yes, so your bones are, all bones are there in your body parts. Okay, yes, understood all of you? Now, okay, you have to tell me right or wrong. Okay, bones are soft.
Wrong.
Yes, very good. Bones are hard. Okay, they are flexible, but they are hard. Okay, the human skeleton protects the internal organs. True or false?
Yes.
True. So what does the human skeleton do? It protects the internal organs. Okay, understood all of you? Yes. Okay, the listen. You have to again tell me. Okay, again tell me. Okay, listen properly. The system which gives a definite shape to our body. Which is the system which gives definite shape to our body?
Skin.
Skeletal system. It gives a proper shape. Okay. In the skeleton, inside the body, there is skeleton. Okay. That is called as bones part. So that is the skeletal system. Okay. The dash joint is seen in the fingers and toes. Which joint can you see?
May I tell, teacher?
Yes, say. Yes.
Hinge joint.
Yes. Joint. Understood, all of you. So this is what you have understood by what I have taught you all today, right? Okay. Any doubt you are having? Which part you have not understood? You can ask me. Okay, I'll ask you one question.
No doubt, teacher. No doubt.
Okay. So smart you all are. Very good, very good. Okay, I'll ask you one question. The human skeletal system is divided into how many parts? Human skeletal system. Human skeletal system. Okay, how many types of bones are there? First. How many types of bones are there? I have taught you yesterday. Types of bones. Four types of bones.
Yes.
I have taught you yesterday four types of bones. Flat bones, small bones, irregular bones and long bones. Okay. These all bones are very much important for our body. What can you say about fractured bones? How will you see from fractured bone? From what type of technology?
May I tell?
From X-ray.
Yes.
Crack.
X-ray.
Very good.
See that fractured.
Yes.
Each bone.
Yes, very good. Okay. Understood, all of you? So, homework. Yesterday's homework. Come on. Who is going to give yesterday's homework? Okay, I'll be asking you. You just give me the answers. Okay? Okay. Heart. What is the function of heart?
Miss, function of heart is pumping blood.
Very good. Then, what is the function of lungs?
More fresh air.
Lungs?
Respiration.
Yes, respiration. Very good, very good. Then brain. What does the brain function?
Means it controls our body.
Body, yes, very good. Coordination and controlling of our body. It commands to each and every organ. Now we have to do this work. Now we have to do that work. Okay. You have to open your mouth. You have to open your eyes. You have to listen. These all things is for our brain is giving command to our body. Yes, very good. Very good, all of you. What about intestines? What does intestine function? First. What is the function of intestine? Yes? Digestion? Can you recollect? Yes, to digest the food. Okay? Yes, very good, all of you. You are giving very nice answers also. Good students. Okay? Good children. Yes, keep it up. So, you have understood our skeletal system and the skin topic. Okay? Question answers we'll be seeing in the next lecture. What I have asked you some questions, you keep in mind and write in your notebook. Okay? Understood, all of you? Okay. That's all for the day today. Thank you, children.